Lectura del profeta Isaías. Escúchenme, islas. Pongan atención, pueblos lejanos. Yahvé me llamó desde el vientre de mi madre. Desde las entrañas maternas pronunció mi nombre. Hizo de mi boca una espada cortante y me escondió debajo de su mano. Hizo de mí una flecha puntiaguda y me guardó en la caja para las flechas. Él me dijo: Tú eres mi servidor, Israel, y por ti me daré a conocer. Mientras que yo pensaba, he trabajado de balde, para nada he gastado mis fuerzas. Vi que mis derechos los protegía Yahvé, y que mi salario lo tenía mi Dios. Fui tomado en cuenta por Yahvé. Mi Dios me prometió su apoyo, y ahora Yahvé ha hablado. El que me formó desde el seno materno para que fuera su servidor, para que le traiga a Jacob y le junte a Israel. No vale la pena que seas mi servidor únicamente para restablecer a las tribus de Jacob o traer sus sobrevivientes a su patria. Te voy a poner, además, como una luz para el mundo, para que mi salvación llegue hasta el último extremo de la tierra. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor. Santo es nuestro Dios.
Es bueno dar gracias al Señor. Es bueno dar gracias al Señor. Es bueno dar gracias al Señor.
Jesús les dijo, vayan a presentarse a los sacerdotes. Mientras iban de camino, quedaron limpios de la lepra. Uno de ellos, al ver que estaba curado, regresó alabando a Dios en voz alta. Se postró a los pies de Jesús y les dio las gracias. Ese era un samaritano. Entonces dijo Jesús, ¿no eran 10 los que quedaron limpios? ¿Dónde están los otros 9? ¿No ha habido nadie fuera de este extranjero que volviera a dar gloria a Dios? Después les dijo el samaritano, levántate y vete, tu fe te ha salvado. The Gospel of the Lord, palabra del Señor. Please be seated. Asiente, por favor. Hoy celebramos los 15 años de Miranda. Le dije a Miranda, a while ago I asked Miranda, Miranda, I will forget your name during the service. So remind me, if I point to you, that means I want you to answer with your name. Isn't that true? Yeah. Why? Because sometimes I miss that airplane. I forget. But today, as we celebrate Miranda's 50th birthday, we should be thinking about a moment of happiness. God has given us so much. And we've gone through a lot during this pandemic too. And just a few years ago, a lot of people are already forgetting about that. Well, I'm here to tell you, COVID is still around. We cannot bring down our guard. I know, I'm a chaplain invader, so I know what's going on. But in getting back to celebration, we should be thankful that God has brought us through a lot during this last years in our lives. And we should be thankful that we can celebrate the gift of life that God has given us. For each and every one of us is a gift from God to us. But what we do with our lives is a gift to God. So what kind of gift are we giving God today? How are we living our lives? Today the world is trying to tell us that we don't need church, that we don't need God, when in reality, it's the opposite. We need God more than ever in our lives. We need God more in our children, our future. We need God more in their lives. Our children need faith today. Today more than ever. That technology, those telephones, is taking our children. In many ways, they are sequestering our children away from us. And more our children are becoming strangers to us. I can say that. How many of us today think they know their children? Raise your hands. See? Used to, not too long ago, before technology, those phones, when I say technology, we almost every parent would raise their hand. Nowadays, in most of the quinceañeras, maybe one person raised a hand and barely like this. Why? They're afraid to hear the answer. You know what the answer is? Those cell phones know our children and know us as adults, as parents, better than anyone except for God. God who knows our hearts. God that knows our minds. God that knows our ways. We cannot forget that. But those cell phones know who we are texting, know who we are calling. What are we saying in those texts and those calls that we make? The pictures that we take, the pictures that we send out, the places that we are always looking into through those phones. Where are we going in those phones? Who are we connecting with? What websites are we going to? The old saying, tell me who you're with, and I'll tell you who you are, has changed. Tell me who you're following in those websites, and I'll tell you who you are. That's what's sad about all of this. Because that technology is taking our identifications, ourselves, taking us out of the picture from our family and friends in many ways. And we think that all of that information that is on those phones stay in those phones? No. Every single word we say or text or picture, it's all being stored in warehouses of information somewhere in the world. So think of it, there is no privacy anymore. Somebody has our history. Now, why am I telling you all of this? Because I want you all, including our young people today, to wake up, to think about what we are doing with that technology. And for us as parents to be more aware that there should be more boundaries around that technology. We need to make sure that our children are not accessing websites that they shouldn't be at. And I tell you why. And we hear it all the time. This is not new. Our children know it's not new. Through those cell phones, I'm making you aware. There's pornography. Pornography of children. There's human trafficking. Trafficking of children. There's bullying. There's drugs selling. So much there is on the dark web. It is sad how our children today are being bombarded with all of this information in their lives. Now, how can we combat something like this? How can we change something like this? It is very easy. Get connected again with God. Not with that phone, with God. Have a one-to-one with God. Talk to God. We seem to forget that we have a God that loved us, that sent His only Son. And His only Son died on the cross for us. So that one day all of us will be together in heaven. But how many of us think about that? How many of us pray with our children today? How many of us will sit at our tables today and say, Lord, thank you for this food we're about to receive? How many of us? How many of us at the table connect with our children as we once did? Not just in Thanksgiving, but today, at least once a week. How many of us pray, Lord, thank you for the food, thank you for my job, thank you for our health? How many of us think that prayer is important in our lives? Yes, more than ever, our children need prayer. They need us more than ever. And when I say us, I mean parents. I mean grandparents, I mean uncles, aunts, friends, family. More than ever, our children need love, attention, communication, and most of all, faith in God. Let us remember, when we baptize our children, we promise God that our children will be educated in the faith of God. And how many of us are taking that responsibility and applying it to their lives and putting our faith in action in front of our children? Because more than ever, our children need us. We may not think so, but they do. More than ever, our children want to be near us. More than ever, our children want to talk to us, communicate with us. They want us to understand what everything they're going through. Why? Because more than ever, our children are afraid. We may not think so. Don't you think they hear the news all the time? They're worried when they go to school. They worry when they go to a mall. They worry whenever they go out with their friends. They worry a lot. Are we taking time with them? Time? It's a gift from God. Time that we share with our children is treasure, is gold. And our children and parents need it more than ever. So, remember, the gift of life is something that we cannot take for granted. It's a gift that God gave us freely to be here, to have a purpose with our children, and for our children to have a purpose in this life. Let us remember that. As we celebrate today, Miranda's 15th birthday? Oh, come Monday. She's ahead of herself today. Good. So, let me ask you a few questions. I told her I was going to ask her a few hundred questions. She got all nervous. What kind of questions? What kind of questions? They're very simple. And if you don't know, I'll help you with them. You ready? Okay. Let me see. Do you remember when you were born? No. Mom, Dad, do you remember? Yeah, like it was yesterday, right? When they carried you for the first time, when they saw you for the first time. What a beautiful sight. A miracle. When we see our children be born, what a miracle God has created in us. She may not remember, but Mom and Dad remember like it was yesterday. Miranda, do you remember when they were feeding you in the little special table and feeding you some Gerber food, maybe some spinach or something, that yellow stuff that they usually give for those little Gerber bottles, you remember? No, they remember. Did she make a mess? Yeah? Do you remember when in the middle of the night you would start crying because you were hungry? Somebody had to get up in the middle of the night and give you that bottle? Do you remember? No. Mom and Dad, which one of you? Good, I'm Dad. See, she's a few. Do you remember when you were crawling? No? Mom and Dad, you remember? When you couldn't stop her, she was going, "Where is Miranda?" She said, "Somewhere. Where is she?" Do you remember when you were starting to learn to walk, and they had you like this, walking around, and you were touching your little toes like this? She had no memory. Why? Because if God wanted to give our children that memory, it was not meant for them. Their memory is meant for mom and dad. Those moments that we spend with our children as they are being born are a gift from God to us. It's not just seeing our children be born, it's seeing them grow in a blink of an eye. And before we know it, mom and dad is saying, scratching their heads and saying, where have the years gone? God. Well, better yet, ask that question. How have I spent that blink of an eye with our children, with my child? What are those moments that God gave us in those moments in life? How did I enjoy those moments? Maybe your mom bathing you. Do you remember when she bathed you in that little? No? I was gonna say the sink in the kitchen, maybe?
Yes.
See? Do you remember when they were changing your diapers, your pampers? No. Do you remember how many sleepless nights you caused your parents to have? And how many worries they had during those times as you were growing up because they had bills to pay? See, our children don't remember that. But mom and dad, those moments were a gift from God. Those moments are treasure. They're gold. Those are the moments that our children write their stories in our hearts. And those are the moments that we leave in their hearts also. Today's celebration is a moment that she will always remember. Always. So how many of us are spending time, gold, treasure? Because time is a gift that comes from God with our children. Remember that. The way to combat all of this technology is to come back and connect with our children today. More than ever. Don't let those phones be your babysitters. Talk to your children. Don't be texting, where are you? I'm over here in my room. When is supper going to be ready? No, none of that. Bring him over. Look him straight in the eyes and say, mijo o mija, son, daughter, how are you doing today here? How are we doing here? Because today, more than ever, even with that technology, there is more depression, more loneliness, more sadness. And our children, no matter what age they are, need us more than ever. And what's sad, today, even today, right now, in the last couple of years, so many suicides of young people and older young people, young adults. We need to be there for them. We need to ask the hard question. Son, daughter, how are you doing here? How are you doing today here? Are you feeling okay? Is there something I can help you with or listen to? Let us open our hearts to listen. Okay, Miranda, ready? Here's the next question. Let me see what I can think of. Oh, this is going to be easy. Okay. And you may think this is strange. Why am I asking this question? Well, we'll find out why. Miranda, how much do you think your mom and dad pay for that roof you're living in today? Oh, that's a good number, a lot. Give me a number. 100, 200, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000? No. A month payment. Oh boy, 200. That's rent, that mortgage is pretty cheap. Okay? That doesn't even buy a week's worth of food. Okay. Let's say 1,000. At $10 an hour, how many hours of his time for that 1,000, for that mortgage or that rent? Yeah, math. Uh-oh. I give up here. Okay, let's say 100 hours of his time for that 1,000. 40 hours a week is 2 weeks and a half. And that's just to pay that mortgage or that rent. Okay? It's only one bill. Miranda, this is a very serious question. You ready? Do you eat sometimes? A little bit or a lot? A lot, a lot. Okay, Miranda. And people are thinking, why is he asking those questions? Well, I want you to see what reality is for our children. Where they're at in their lives. How much they understand about how hard it is for us to give our children a place to be, to live, and eat. Okay, so how much do you think they spend on food a week?
Like 300.
Okay, about 300? Less, 200? Let's say 200. Yeah. 2, 4, 6, 8. That's 800 a month. How many hours at $10 an hour? No, I'll be here all day. Let's say 80 hours, so that's 2 more weeks. Oh, she was going to say that. Okay. I got ahead of myself. So that's 2 more weeks of his salary, okay? Of his work. That's only 2 bills. They still have to pay water, gas, electric, or else they'll shut it off, especially during the wintertime. Well, even if we pay, that electricity goes away sometimes. Shoes, dress, gasoline to take you to school. What else? You have a cell phone? Uh-oh. Yeah, your angel, your guardian angel takes care of you. Okay. But you see what they have to do, the sacrifices they have to make for you. What does your dad do? What does he work in?
He did trucks,
he did drive his trucks. Oh, okay. And you think his job is easy? You never asked him?
No.
Have you ever gone with him on a trip somewhere? Nah.
I wish I would, but she can't.
No? She can't? Maybe in the future.
Yeah.
Does your mom work? What does your mom do?
She did like
3 years. Okay. And you think her job is easy?
No.
For you see, our children don't understand what mom and dad go through to give them a roof and give them food and give them a place and dress them, for 15 years. They've made a lot of sacrifices. For who? For you. Why do you think they do that? Because they loved you even before you were born. When you were still in your mom's little tummy, they still loved you. So remember that. A lot of times our children, they lose that enthusiasm to be someone in this world, to study hard, to be what they want to be, what God intended them to be. Hardworking, studious children with faith. Just remember, how many people are trying to cross that border because they dream that one day they want to see their children be born here and triumph here. And a lot of our children have opportunities and they take them for granted. They don't do anything with those gifts that God has given us. So inspire your children. Talk to your children. Communicate with your children. Because they have dreams. They have dreams. What do you want to do when you finish high school? What is it that you want to study or do? She doesn't know yet, but she wants to be rich. Okay, but rich doesn't come overnight. Rich doesn't come if you win the lottery, because even people that have won the lottery, within a year or two, they're poor again. Rich comes when you have blessings, when you have a family that loves you, a family that supports you, friends that are real friends to you. That's where the rich of life comes in. And the many gifts that God gives each and every one of us. So the greatest gift you can give your mom and dad right now is seeing you finish high school. They want to see you with that diploma. That's how you make them proud. And then if you decide to go to the university, you're going to make them more proud. Because that's what parents dream of. They want to see their children do something in their lives to be proud of. For example, if one of our children becomes a lawyer, mom and dad, I have a son that's a lawyer. I have a son that's a doctor. I have a daughter that's a nurse. That's how they are proud of their children. When their children make them proud. So make your family proud. Make your parents proud of the decisions that you're making even today. So, you have a cell phone. Two words of advice. When you're talking to your mom and dad, look at them in the eyes and say, put your phone down. Don't be, yes, mom, sure, mom, no. Because you're breaking the fourth commandment. Honor thy father and thy mother. Talk to them. For we never know when God might call you. Are you ready? No, you never are. When you're talking to your friends, and you have quite a few of them here, put your phone down. Look at them in the eyes and say to them, how are you doing here? How are you doing here today? Because you never know that they need somebody to talk to. Because they might be going through hard times, even in their own families. Maybe somebody is bullying them, and we don't know. Only they know what they're going through. And unless we ask, And unless we show that we care, we will never know. So put your phones down. When you're at the kitchen table, put your phone down. Pray. Thank you, Lord, for this food we're about to receive. Very easy. So, next question is a very important one. And look at it. Ready? Do you have any secrets from mom or dad? That smile and those eyes gave me 1,000 words. I'll give you one word of advice. A few words. Don't have any secrets from them. Because your mom probably already knows your secrets, but she wants you to open your heart and share it with her. There's no one else that knows, that has the experience that your mom has already, because she's already lived a few years more than you. Just a few. So, do you know how to cook? Tortillas? Or not more from the store? Don't say that. Oh, never mind. Okay, I knew that was coming. Arroz and frijoles? Rice and beans? Look at mom, look at you. You're going to have to show me. Okay, here's the deal. This is homework for both of you. You ready? When you're in the kitchen, experimenting with God's food, with your dad's food, poor God, okay? Talk to your mom. Open your heart. Maybe she'll share some of the recipes. And that's what you connect again. Talk. Open your hearts. Communicate with your children. Talk to them. Come down to their level. They might have to. We might have to go up to their level. We need to communicate with our children. Show them how much we love them. And the responsibility that God gave us was to give our children their faith. Share our faith with them. Remember that. So Miranda, may God bless you. And that all your dreams may come true. Let us pray. Let us get together. Mom and Dad on this side. Padrinos on that side. Godparents. Whatever they call them nowadays. Godparents. Well, padrinos, are they here? Grandfather and grandmother, are they here? Yeah, come over here. Uncles and aunts? Oh, no. Okay, that's too many. The whole church will get up. Well, let us stand. Miranda, do you remember when you were baptized? She doesn't have any memory anymore. So remember, that day they did the profession of faith. Let us all help her to the profession of faith. Do you reject sin as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, and rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, in your words, Mom and Dad, each one of you will give her a blessing in your own words. Please turn around, get closer to her. Now, please kneel. If there are any gifts that we need to be blessed, please bring them up. And we will bless Miranda, reminding us that we are all children of God through our baptism. We bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May this article and the ones who use them be blessed in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Vision in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of our personal intentions, there are deep inside our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Loving Creator, we come to you with this petition which we offer to you, because we are in need of your help. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
On that, amigos, abuelos.
It's not every day that we celebrate 15 years of Miranda. It's not every day that we celebrate in the church the gift of life that God has given each and every one of us. So in those words, Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say or sing. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Thank you. would like to receive the Holy Eucharist. Mm-hmm. In your words, right now, thank Mom and Dad. Come, Mom and Dad, get close to them. Not from a distance. Give them a hug. It replaces a lot of those sentiments. You know, when they're nervous, they start smiling, you know. So I'm young. Okay, are you going to thank them also for being? The gospel today tells us and reminds us to teach our children to be thankful for what they have. We receive a lot of blessings throughout our lives, and we forget to thank the one that gave us the gift of life. So teach our children their faith. Teach them to say thank you. Only two words. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad. The other one that's very hard to say, I love you, Mom. I love you, Dad. I don't know why it's so hard for them to say it. But it's so easy. And you know, it's so easy to get to their hearts and we show our parents how much, and we tell them how much we love them and appreciate everything that they've done for us. Remember. Let us pray. Holy Father, we ask you to look kindly on your daughter Miranda here at your altar. She has come to celebrate the gift of life you have given her through the holy union of her parents. Strengthen her in that faith which brought her here today. Through the gifts of the Holy Spirit, guide her way through life as you guided your favorite daughter, the Virgin Mary. So may this young lady be always pleasing to you. Inspire others to know you and love you and serve you through their life they live fully. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, who reigns, lives, and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us give a hand to Miranda. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us glorify God with our lives. We may go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Señor, te damos gracias por la vida, la tierra y el sol. Oh Señor, queremos cantar las grandezas de tu amor. Gracias, Padre, mi vida es tu vida. Tus manos amasan mi barro.
get past it.
I see the lights, they're on so bright.
Find my way to you.
Tengo dos excusas en mi mente para recortar mi día y a mi casa regresar. Son un par de mágicas princesas con pijamas y con trenzas que juegan a ser mamá. Ya se han dado cuenta que soy débil y con solo una sonrisa pueden todo conseguir. De mi corazón se han vuelto dueños y me alegran la existencia con solo en ellas pensar. Entre gimnasia y la tarea van creciendo muy deprisa.
This makes a noise for the parents, Marco and Mayra Martínez, acompañado de la quinceañera, la princesa. Fuerte el aplauso. Miranda Martínez. Les llegan fuertes los aplausos. Big round of applause. Come on, guys. Nice and loud. Who's the quinceañera tonight? Miranda Martínez. All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, father and daughter dance.
For all working so hard. Thank you so much for making this day possible. I love you so, so, so much.
Mi niñita más querida.
but this was a father and daughter dance tonight. Continuamos con la coronación. Vamos a comenzar con los padrinos de los zapatos, the shoes. If we can please have Damien and Nina Oliva. Fuerte el aplauso para ellos. Please turn around for the picture real quick. Así también entregan su ramo de flores con dinerito, por favor, sonrían para la cámara. Muchas gracias, fuerte aplauso para los padrinos de los zapatos, Damián y Nina Oliva, esta noche, gracias. Continuamos con la corona, the crown. We can please have Claudia Colbert, please, with the crown.
Thank you.
Big round of applause, please. Los sonidos de los aretes, earrings. Big round of applause, Eric Oliva and Silvia Guerrero. Al centro de la pista, por favor. Sanchez. See you. some hot boots for the cold weather. We got a cold front coming next week. Aplausos para ellos. Raúl El Viaje Cantú. Los padrinos del Legado Sorpresa. Así pasa el centro de la pista, el papá Marco Martínez que va a bailar con su hija. La última muñeca, fuerte el aplauso.
Nunca nos damos cuenta de cómo un rosal crece. Hasta el día que florece la rosa una mañana. Quisiéramos que fueran nuestros hijos niños siempre. Pero de repente, un día, les brotan alas. Compré a mi niña el último juguete. No me había dado cuenta de lo que ya creció. Se acabó el entusiasmo, ya se acabó aquel brete. Y a ver qué trajo papi, ahora que volvió. Pues le compré a mi niña el último juguete. No me había dado cuenta de lo que ya creció. Hoy que me dio el abrazo de bienvenida, noté que está más alta y que se perfumó. Como pasaron cosas en unos cuantos días, abrió maravillosa, se hizo rosa el botón. Hoy le compré a mi niña la última muñeca, no me había dado cuenta. Se está haciendo mujer. Hoy le compré a mi niña la última muñeca. La última muñeca y ni se la enseñé. Y ahora se pasa horas y horas en los espejos. Ya se mira de frente, de espalda, de perfil. Ahora ya ni me dice, papi, cuéntame un cuento. Y a veces ni me besa cuando se va a dormir. Hoy que me dio el abrazo de bienvenida, noté que está más alta y que se perfumó. Como pasaron cosas en unos cuantos días, abrió maravillosa, se hizo rosa el botón. Hoy le compré a mi niña la última muñeca, no me había dado cuenta, se está haciendo mujer. Hoy le compré a mi niña la última muñeca, la última muñeca. Y ni se la enseñé.
Big round of applause. For the Quinceañera and her father. Continuamos con el baile con su abuelito, por favor, al centro de la pista. Eleuterio Martínez, que va a bailar una canción. Hola, Quinceañera.
Thank you. muñequita, Dios, preciosa. Vamos que hay que celebrar tus 15 años de edad primorosa. Vamos, ya no hay que esperar. Y yo sé que no hay baile mejor. Vamos que ya están tocando este vals del amor. 15 años son muchos y es una sentencia. Mas 100 son poquitos rodeados de amor. Voy a arrodillarme frente a la presencia del máximo juez, del divino creador. Voy a suplicarle que por tu inocencia te sentencie a ser de sus jardines flor. Y cuando él decida quién deba cortarte, tengo fe en que sea la mano mejor. 15 años son muchos si pienso en 90. 100 más son poquitos si pienso en vivir para verte alegre, para protegerte y colgarme el premio, y colgarme el premio de tu sonrisa. Tal como siempre soñé, repicaron campanas al viento. Se realizó la ilusión. 15 años, qué bello momento. Vamos, ya no hay que esperar. Ya verás que no hay baile mejor. Vamos, porque están tocando este vals del amor.
Ya su cuerpo, fuerte el aplauso para el abuelito, el señor. Eugenio Martínez, gracias.
Estamos orgullosos.
attention, we'll be right back in about 5 minutes. A ver, volteen para la foto, por favor. Regresamos en 5 minutos, se van a cambiar por ahí la quinceañera y vamos a presentar a los chambelanes.
Introduction of the court, we start with Sebastián Caneón and Emma Cantu. Pesito Pluma. Continuamos con Julián Cantú, acompañado con Marisa Sánchez. Coming up next, Camila Florido and Matthew Flores. Up next, Jose Carrion and Anna Lee Oliva. Continuamos con Juan de Ser, acompañado con Magdalena Martínez. Coming up next, Alessandro Ontiveros and Aileen Tolson. Coming up next, Tevin Figueroa and Giselle Salas. Damas y caballeros, que llega muy fuerte el aplauso para la quinceañera, la princesa de esta noche, acompañada con el chambelán de honor, Matthew Sotelo and Miranda Martínez. Damas y caballeros, continuamos con el vals. Thank you. Big round of applause for the Charmeland de Honor. Ya estamos listos por ahí. Damas y caballeros, fuerte aplauso. Esto es el baile sorpresa.
vieja que no baile, yo la pongo a bailar. La vieja que no goce, yo la pongo a gozar. La vieja que no brinque, yo la pongo a brincar. Y a todas las mujeres, yo la pongo a perrear.
Palmas, 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 todas, palmas, palmas, palmas. Palmas, palmas, palmas. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Damas y caballeros, fuerte el aplauso para ellos. El baile sorpresa esta noche, gracias. Start forming the line at this time, please. Invitamos a los familiares, a los tíos, a las tías, a los primos, las primas que pasen a participar en el baile del Dona de esta noche. Uncles, aunts, cousins, family members, to the Dona dance.
Thank you. llegó conquistando corazones. Ya llegó la morrita que yo quiero y el primero aquí soy yo con muy serias intenciones. Porque me gusta cómo ella baila y cómo luce su minifalda y en sus ojitos color de cielo. Cuando me miran yo me congelo. Su rico movimiento y me gustó la morrita por su modo de mirar. Mi corazón ahora sí que está contento, muy contento. ¡Hey, señor! ¡Hey! Y me gustó la morrita por su forma de bailar. Me cautivó con su rico movimiento y me gustó la morrita por su modo de mirar. Mi corazón ahora sí que está contento.
Esa última muñeca, ah, no sé, claro. Cumbia, cumbia. Esto es el Valle del Dólar. Pásenle en forma una linda esta noche. Una quinceañera.
Deseo que me ames, aunque sea tu manera. Deseo que me quieras de una forma sincera. tiemble de amor. Son unos ojos tan primorosos, ojos más lindos no he visto yo. Y todos dicen que no te quiero, que no te adoro con frenesí. Y yo les digo que
¿quién más falta por ahí? ¿Quién más falta? Vale del dólar. Ya menos terminamos. Unos minutos más. Pásale, pásale. Last chance, guys. We've got a few minutes. Sing the dollar dance tonight.
Genial, las manos.
Copas in the air. Alright guys, so not really good at speeches, so I'm gonna say a little bit, so not really, but I just wanna thank God for just making all this happen, and my family and friends for the support and helping us out, and Miga, you have made your mom and I very proud, and we love you so much, man.
I'm not good at speeches either, so I wrote mine down so that I wouldn't, I'm probably still going to stutter a little bit, but I'm just going to read what I wrote. First, I would like to thank God for allowing us to make it to this very moment. 15 years ago, when Miranda was born, me and Mark were young parents who didn't know what we were doing. We once even called my mom freaking out because Miranda wouldn't stop crying. Turns out she just needed a change of diaper. I say all that to say that we wouldn't be where we are without our village. Every single one of you has made an impact on Miranda's life in a positive way, and for that we are so grateful. Her grandparents, her tías, tíos, friends of ours, friends of hers, school teachers, and coaches. We appreciate you all more than you'll ever know. Yaya, I'm so proud of the young lady you are becoming. You're so smart and driven, and most of all, you're not scared to push yourself to the limit. You're a great daughter, sister, granddaughter, niece, cousin, friend. Don't forget to always be nice to yourself and to love yourself first. I know you know this, but I still want to tell you, we will always love you. We will always be here for you no matter what you go through in life. Now, we want to say thank you to everyone for coming to celebrate this special day with us. I would also like to thank each and every person who helped in any way, big or small, to make this day happen. We love you all so much, and we are so happy that you guys are here. So, iba a decir todo eso en español, pero ya me ganaron los nervios. Pero voy a decir que estamos tan orgullosos de Miranda. Estamos tan orgullosos de ella. No, la queremos mucho y estamos muy contentos porque todos están aquí a celebrar con nosotros. Muchas gracias a todos por venir y a cada persona que nos ayudó a hacer este día posible. Muchas gracias.
I just want to say thank you to everyone who came today and just helped in any way. Just for anything, all of my padrinos and everybody, anybody who helped. And I'm just so, 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 so grateful for everyone here today just to be here to support and just help make this day possible. Thank you. And to my court, thanks y'all. So.
Y'all are the best.
Gracias a todos.
Go Packers.
We won.
Go Cowboys. Okay, todos para arriba. Para abajo, para el centro y para adentro. Salud, fuerte el aplauso para la quinceañera de esta noche, Miranda Martínez. Muchas gracias por acompañarnos aquí esta noche. You guys ready to party? Make some noise.
Todo lo malo echa pa' allá.
All right, guys, I know this song. I'm about to play this. I know you guys know this song. You guys know this song right here. Vamos a bailar el caballo de rodeo. El payaso de rodeo con el robot. Vamos a ver si se la saben. Vamos a ver todos a la pista. Here we go. Mano derecha para arriba, dice. Here we go, salt to the right, here we go. Rápidamente los niños, por favor. Cuidado con el robot porque no los pueden mirar, ok, está muy altote. Así que un paladito, por favor, no los vayan a machucar.
Two, featuring the Platinum Band, and this time we're gonna get funky, 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 funky. Everybody clap your hands, clap, 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 clap your hands,
clap, clap, clap,
clap, clap,
clap your hands.
Take it back now, y'all.
side hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right.